In this video, I'm going to cover glycogen metabolism, that is, the synthesis of glycogen from glucose-6-phosphate and the breakdown of glycogen to produce glucose-6-phosphate. Before we get into details of that, I want to be clear that the monosaccharide glucose is a major source of energy, or ATP, for cells. Glucose can be broken down to provide energy through glycolysis, the citric acid cycle, and oxidative phosphorylation. Glucose-6-phosphate, or G6P, is simply glucose with an added phosphate, and so G6P also represents energy to the cell. But sometimes, instead of using G6P to make ATP, cells will store it away as glycogen. Remember that glycogen is just a large polymer composed of a great many glucose monomers joined together in a specific way. Each circle on this diagram represents one glucose monomer. Glycogen is a form of energy storage found mainly in two types of tissue in your body, in the liver and in muscles. But these tissues store glycogen for different reasons. Glycogen in a skeletal muscle cell exists as an energy reserve for that cell. The goal of glycogen breakdown in muscle is to allow the cell, when it is running low in ATP, to make more ATP through these oxidation pathways. In contrast, glycogen in a liver cell is not stored for use by that cell, but exists as an energy reserve for the entire body. When the concentration of glucose in the blood falls, the liver breaks down glycogen and releases glucose into the bloodstream. This supplies the body's tissues with glucose, especially the brain, which has high energy needs and predominantly uses glucose as a source of energy. Now, let's look in detail at how glycogen and G6P are interconverted. In liver and muscle cells, when G6P is abundant, some is converted to glucose-1-phosphate, or G1P. This is an equilibrium reaction that moves the phosphate group from carbon-6 to carbon-1. Then, G1P can be added to an existing glycogen polymer in a reaction catalyzed by the enzyme glycogen synthase. This reaction involves the hydrolysis of UTP to UDP and phosphate. This hydrolysis reaction is similar to the hydrolysis of ATP to ADP and phosphate in that it is energetically favorable. So this reaction is used to make the addition of G1P to glycogen energetically favorable. UTP is called an ATP equivalent in this reaction because it serves the same role that ATP very often plays in driving a biochemical reaction toward products. Glycogen synthase makes alpha-1,4 linkages between glucose monomers. A separate enzyme handles making the branch points in glycogen, but for simplicity, I'm not going to talk about that enzyme. When the liver or muscle cell wants to break glycogen down to produce monosaccharides, an enzyme called glycogen phosphorylase uses a phosphate ion from solution to remove glucose from the polymer as G1P. G1P is then converted to G6P. As with glycogen synthesis, branch points are handled by a separate enzyme that I'm not going to discuss. Now, note that breakdown of glycogen is not simply the direct reverse process of glycogen synthesis. Glycogen synthesis requires energy input in the form of hydrolysis of UTP to UDP and phosphate. In contrast, glycogen breakdown by glycogen phosphorylase is energetically favorable in the cell and proceeds spontaneously if the enzyme is active. These are two different reactions proceeding by different mechanisms and catalyzed by different enzymes. In contrast, the interconversion of G1P and G6P is a reversible reaction that is near equilibrium and is catalyzed by a single enzyme. Which direction is favored depends completely on the relative concentrations of G1P and G6P. So when the concentration of G6P is high, its conversion to G1P is favored by Le Chatelier's principle. When the concentration of G1P is high, this reaction favors conversion of G1P to G6P. In the next video, I'll talk about how glycogen synthesis and breakdown are regulated.